Hi, I'm JT,
and this is Rehana.
Hi everyone!
Welcome to the Movie Club.
This episode is for older people, and today we're going to be talking about Nomadland. Directed by Chloe Zhao and the winner of pretty much every significant award this year at the Oscars.
Nomadland tells the story of Fern, an average American living in a mining town where the only employer closes down, making her houseless.
It is a tough time right now. You may want to consider early retirement.
I need work. I like work.
What's the difference between houseless and homeless?
My mom said that you're homeless. Is that true?
No, I'm not homeless. I'm just houseless. Not the same thing, right?
No.
This movie makes a clear distinction of people who are nomadic by choice. Although it's fair to admit that Fern and many of the other people that she meets are driven to their lifestyle by either financial or emotional distress.
You are one of those lucky people that can travel anywhere.
Yes, ma'am, I know.
And they sometimes call you nomads.
What makes this movie really fascinating is that most of the people who feature in Nomadland are real people rather than actors. Although the actors it does have are fantastic.
So we have Frances McDormand, who has been fantastic in basically everything from Fargo to Three Billboards, and David Strahan as her sort of love interest Dave.
I think Frances McDormand is really one of the best actors of her generation. She brings a deep level of humanity to the character of Fern. I find it interesting that some actors spend a fortune on Botox and personal trainers to maintain an illusion of perfection, while others choose to age naturally and provide increasingly interesting and nuanced performances that would be impossible without the ability to raise your eyebrows.
Absolutely love how women just basically disappear after the age of 40 and then turn up at 60 as Dame Helen Mirren.
It is fascinating. Unfortunately, only Dame Helen Mirren can really pull that off. So let's talk about the cinematography.
This film showcases some of the most beautiful and desolate landscapes in America, courtesy of the cinematographer Joshua James Richards, who has been a longtime collaborator of director Chloe Zhao.
Yeah, it's funny, when I was watching this movie, I couldn't help be reminded of the outback scenes in Easy Rider. It was, of course, made back in 1969.
I've never seen Easy Rider.
It's a trip, man. But back to Nomadland. This movie looks amazing, and the stories that the people tell are often heartbreaking. Real people, real stories.
My dad used to say, what's remembered lives. I maybe spent too much of my life just remembering.
But I think if I have one criticism of this movie, and I don't think it's an original criticism, it's that it feels a little bit aimless, much like Fern herself.
Hey, it's another beautiful landscape and more people living in caravans.
Yeah, that's right. It's a minor quibble. It's such a well-done movie. It's definitely worth checking out, particularly if you ever considered packing up all of your worldly goods and moving into a van and hitting the road.
One of the things I love most about this life is that there's no final goodbye. I've met hundreds of people out here, and I don't ever say a final goodbye. Let's just say I'll see you down the road.
Nomadland is now streaming on Disney+.
This was the Movie Club, movies for older people. If you enjoyed this review, please click the subscribe button below.
Thanks, guys. See you next week.